as the back-to-back Grey Cup champs celebrate another title. It's also a special evening for us here at TSN as we celebrate 25 years of Friday Night Football tonight. I almost had to sing it. It's that exciting. Friday Night Football tonight. Here we go.
Yeah, geez, I was still playing when this Friday Night Football thing started, so it's been a while.
But you've had a good run. I think we've all had a good run, and we're looking forward to a really good game tonight and a lot on the line for both of these teams as they start the season with everything that Winnipeg is bringing to the table, and obviously a guy that had a lot of success last year.
Yeah, absolutely. Zach Collaros enters his second full season with the Winnipeg Blue Bombers, already with two Grey Cup rings under his belt, so off to a terrific start, looking to join a select group that have won three in a row. And a huge acquisition for the Ottawa REDBLACKS in the offseason. The other quarterback in that Grey Cup decision last year, Jeremiah Masoli, comes over from Hamilton, brings a whole lot of other free agents with him as the REDBLACKS look to reverse their fortunes here in 2022.
Yeah, he's a fun new weapon for that man. Paul LaPolice, second head coach season here in Ottawa. First trip back to Winnipeg since he won a Grey Cup with the Bombers in 2019, so a special night for him. And of course, Mike O'Shea, back-to-back Grey Cups, unbeaten at home last year as well. So they've got obviously high expectations coming in to this season for Mike O'Shea, and he's on both ends of Friday Night Football history as Mike O'Shea, as he played in the first FNF game back on June 27, 1997, and stars galore in this one as Doug Flutie passed for 438 yards, ran for another 116, and threw four touchdowns, including that one to Hall of Famer Mookie Mitchell. TSN's own Milt Stegall, look at his shoes here. Beautiful 59-yard touchdown in a losing effort as O'Shea's Argos defeated the Bombers 38-23. Now here is Sarah Orleski with now coach O'Shea.
Mike, you played in the first Friday Night Football game. You've coached in a lot of them as well. When you think of the CFL and Friday Night Football, what comes to mind?
Well, I think from humble beginnings, Friday Night Football and TSN has just become a great Canadian tradition, right? I just picture Canadians across the country getting on their couch, sitting on the end of their dock, wherever it is, in front of the TV at a bar, putting on the Friday Night Football. And it's to be a part of it for 25 years, I guess I'm old, but it's been fun.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
And it's been fun. We're set up for a fun night. Last night was great in the Canadian Football League. Looking forward to see what these two teams can do here this evening.
Yeah, and this is a very interesting matchup. And obviously, again, you've got two quarterbacks who faced each other in last year's Grey Cup game. The Winnipeg Blue Bombers come into this season, obviously, as favorites to get back to the big game. A lot of continuity for their team, but a lot of excitement in Ottawa. The great unknown as to how all these new players who look great on paper are gonna gel together.
Yeah, a lot of changes for Ottawa, and we'll break them down as we work our way through the night. Not this guy, though, who's about to kick us off. He was their one all-star last year as Richie Leone lets this thing fly, and that will come down to Grant at his own 14. Denarian Grant had some big moments last year in the return game, stays on his feet here, pushes ahead, and an excellent second effort to start this game for the Bombers, and decent field position for Zach Collaros.
Collaros coming off the first MOP award of his career, also named the Grey Cup MVP, as you see at the bottom. An absolutely tremendous season for Zach. A terrific touchdown to interception ratio, led the league as well.
He will start on his own 39. Three receivers to his left, three including his running back Oliveira out to his right. Empty backfield, moves it quickly, he's got a completion, and that'll be taken just outside the 45 to Nick Dembski. Let's take a look at the starting offense for the Bombers, brought to you by Expedia.
Yeah, a few new faces out there for the Bombers. Jeff Gray has been with the team. He takes over at guard for Drew Desjarlais, who's pursuing some NFL opportunities at running back. Of course, Andrew Harris has moved on. Brady Oliveira and Johnny Augustine expected to split time filling that role. Of course, Darvin Adams now in Ottawa. Kenny Lawler moving on from that receiving core. Greg Ellingson moves in, coming over in free agency from Edmonton.
A lot of opportunity offensively here for Bombers, and there's a completion. And that one is gunned in there as well to Greg Ellingson. Let's take a look at this REDBLACKS defense.
Yeah, Red Blacks defense with a few new faces. Lorenzo Malden, another former Ticat. He'll get the start at defensive end here tonight. Patrick Levels, a big acquisition, part of a trio coming over from Montreal. He's at that nickel linebacker spot. On the back end, veteran Justin Howell has been one of the special teams leaders for this team. Won a hotly contested battle at the free safety spot in training camp. He gets the start there. Antoine Pruneau had been the regular starter.
First and 10 on the 53. They'll hand it off. Pick up a couple of yards. Take it out to about the 50 for Brady Oliveira.
Of course, we're all familiar with the football journey of Zach Collaros. He's battled a lot of adversity over the course of his CFL career in the way of injuries, but there you see how well things have gone for him as a Winnipeg Blue Bomber. That 17-2 record, a couple Grey Cup rings.
This is his 20th start. He's already got two Grey Cups with this team. It's insane. Collaros with some time, and he's got another completion as he is moving this ball around the offense. That time, he gets it into the hands of one of the new pieces, one of the new weapons, Dalton Schoen.
Six-man protection here, clean pocket for Collaros to zip it in there, just a little bit short of the first down. That'll bring out about a kicking situation. Mark Leggio on to punt.
First drive for Collaros, 3 of 3 for 24 yards, but they do stall just on Ottawa's side of the field. Leggio set to kick it away. He's handling all three kicking duties this season so far, Lisa. Kick that wobbles down there, and Williams will grab it and hang on. So that is where the Red Blacks will start with this man, Jeremiah Mazzoli. High expectations, taking over the quarterback position in Ottawa after a long, something new, something fresh for Mazzoli here in Ottawa.
Yeah, change of scenery for him. He brings along Jalen Acklin as part of his receiving core and center, Darius Sirocco, other former Ticats along that offense. So the guy he's receiving the snap from and one he'll be throwing to are at least familiar.
And the first pass in the direction of Darvin Adams comes up incomplete. Let's take a look at this Red Blacks offense.
Yeah, many new faces. One of the keys though will be at that left tackle spot, problem spot for the Red Blacks last year. Yukembri Williams comes over from Calgary to solidify that spot. And of course, Darvin Adams, the targeted receiver on that first play. 6 seasons with the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. He is reunited with his head coach and offensive coordinator, Paul LaPolice, in Ottawa.
Just two returning starters on offense for the Red Blacks. Mazzoli over the middle. Adams reached back for it. And the former Bomber hauls it in for a first down.
And no doubt happy to have that one under his belt in his return to Investors Group Field. Adams in a little bit of traffic. As you said, twisting back to make the grab there.
441 yards with Winnipeg last year, 4 touchdowns as well, at a couple 1,000-yard seasons here. Mazzoli now hands it off, and this would be pushed right up the middle by Devontae Williams, and that'll give us a chance to dive into this Bombers defense.
Yeah, we'll take a look. Many to keep an eye on, of course, Willie Jefferson among them. His running mate, Jackson Jeffcoat, out of the lineup tonight with injury. Adam Big Hill, the force in the middle of that defense. He'll be flanked by rookie Donald Rutledge on the strong side. And on the back end, Dietrich Nichols, one of the great rookies from last season, continues at that boundary halfback spot. We'll keep an eye on newcomer Malcolm Thompson at free safety.
Second and 5 for Mazzoli. He's going to look down the field inside the 30, and it's dropped. A great pass from Mazzoli. And unable to haul it in, Jalen Acklin.
Yeah, great route. You see Acklin using that waggle to get a good takeoff. He's untouched, gets separation. Maybe too much time to think about that one. As it flew through the air, he got himself so open. In tight to the body and off the pads.
Gonna see those two connect quite often this year. This is kicked away from about the Ottawa 20. Grant takes it at his own 31. Good kick from Leone. Now Grant right back up the middle. Takes it out just inside his own 45 for the Bombers. Zach Kolaris, 3 of 3 for 24 yards, and he's about to get the ball back in a scoreless game here on Friday Night Football. In Winnipeg, also part of an exclusive club that added another member just last season.
Yeah, here you see the only quarterbacks in Canadian Football League history to win back-to-back Grey Cups. Some great names. Kenny Plain, of course, the great Russ Jackson. The Edmonton Dynasty with Tom Wilkinson followed by Warren Moon. Doug Flutie, more recently Anthony Calvillo, and of course, the last couple, Zach Kolaris.
The only one to do it 3 times, Warren Moon, so an opportunity to join some even a leader company for Kolaris this season. Hands it off and a good push ahead that time. Nice carry from Oliveira, who obviously has some big shoes to fill, but we did see a lot of him last year.
Yeah, it's certainly filling from within for the Bombers. So we take a look at the work of Zach Kolaris. Terrific season for him, second in the league in passing yards. Number 2 in accuracy, number 1 overall in that quarterback efficiency rating. Of course, great win-loss record and the touchdown to interception ratio.
Now he's going to look down the field for Ellingson. A little bump there and a flag does fly. It was Justin Howell as Ellingson tried to cut in and around him. And there was certainly some contact on the play.
Pass interference, Ottawa, number 21. Spot of the foul, first down.
Yeah, here you see Ellingson as he tries to make that break to the middle. Working to the football, Howell with eyes on the receiver. Has to stick an arm out. Kind of lost track of where the ball was. Impeding the receiver from getting to that football.
Ottawa 32 is where Winnipeg is going to go to work. They'll hand it off again. Oliveira decides to put his head down and push it inside the 30. Another good first down pickup for Brady Oliveira.
Well, Brady Oliveira now in his 3rd season with the Bombers. Saw significant duty last year, as you mentioned, Dustin, with Andrew Harris battling injuries. You know, and it, obviously as hard as it is for, I think, everybody in Winnipeg to see Andrew Harris, local hero, legend, very productive player, move on, but there's kind of a natural progression here.
24 years old is Oliveira. Kolaris, good job moving around, now flips it over the top. Are you kidding me? Gets it into the hands of Oliveira. Down inside the 10, Oliveira towards the end zone. Stop just short. What a play by the quarterback and his running back.
Well, I found myself thinking as Zach Kolaris stepped up towards the line of scrimmage, is he going to run? We don't see Zach run very often anymore. Just at that moment, had the perfectly placed dish to Brady Oliveira, who was coming across the formation.
How about the touch on that, eh?
Terrific play all around from Kolaris, maneuvering the pocket to buy himself a little bit of time when things broke down, and Oliveira getting himself in position to help out his QB.
Prukop into the game now. He's going to turn around and hand it off. And there is nowhere to go this time. Oliveira stuffed up. And Kolaris will come right back out onto the field. So looks like the Bombers are going to use Prukop in a similar situation that he's been used for in his career so far. They got Drew Brown, obviously, a quarterback as well.
Yeah, Prukop expected primarily to be the short yardage guy, at least to start the season. Veteran CFLer who's seen time in Toronto, Calgary, Edmonton previously as well.
Second and goal from the 5 for the home side. Back-to-back Grey Cup champs looking to start on the right foot again. Kolaris waits, has a man wide open. Touchdown, Winnipeg! Greg Ellingson, a Friday night icebreaker for the home side.
Well, I love the execution here for the Winnipeg offense. Zach Kolaros on the sprint. You'll see how he threatens the corner. That's going to spread out the defense. He's got Oliveira headed to the flat. Opens up windows. There's Ellingson right in front of him as everybody's kind of starting to roll towards that sideline with the flow of the play. He just has a little drop off there just past the goal line to the veteran free agent signing, Greg Ellingson.
Ellingson just one touchdown last year in Edmonton. And if you're wondering how much he's got left in the tank, I think that has been answered as they have got Ellingson involved early in this offense with Zach Kolaros and this man right here, Ellingson, TD number one with the Bombers.
Yeah, he certainly has. Comes exactly as advertised. Veteran receiver, good teammate. Provides that leadership, presence, reliability, and productivity as a receiver. Delivering very early on here.
It's a six-play, 66-yard drive. Only took 3 minutes and 22 seconds. Kolaros. 5 for 5 for 53 yards and a touchdown as they will kick this away. It'll be taken just inside the 18 and now brought back up the middle of the field, spinning and taken down just outside the 47 on the return. How's this for a comparison?
Yeah, I'll tell you what, I think often, in my opinion, Jeremiah Masoli is a guy who has been underrated as a Canadian Football League quarterback, and there's maybe no stat that tells it more than this. You look at quarterbacks in their careers, the highest percentage of their starts being 300-yard passing games, the fact that he's right there just ahead of Doug Flutie.
Starts at his own 47, has a completion, and this could be a big one all the way down inside the 40, still going down to the 25 before he's taken down. Nate Bahar coming up big for the visitors.
Nate Bahar, the lone holdover in this Ottawa receiving corps. He's coming from the number three spot in the slot. Just a quick slant. Off play action, quick look. The big gain there for Ottawa. High percentage play.
First and 10 from the 25. Pressure coming here. They hand it off, and it's going to be brought right back up the middle by Devontae Williams. And he jumps his way inside the 20.
Devontae Williams, the rookie, getting the start at running back this evening. William Powell starts on the IR. He's got some Canadian Football League roots. Williams, the nephew of former CFL DB Omar Evans. I am told that the rest of the family is home watching the game tonight, cheering on young Williams.
He's got 10 yards and a couple of carries so far. Stands in there to the left of Mazzoli, second and five from the Bomber 20. Mazzoli, now he's going to look towards the end zone. Got him! Touchdown, Ottawa! As he sends it deep and finds Shaq Johnson. And how about this for an answer from the visitors?
Yes, Skinny!
Told you!
Yes, sir!
Come on, let's go! Let's go!
Yeah, and you've got to like this on a couple of counts for Ottawa. Obviously, the immediate response after a Winnipeg touchdown, but also you look at their last offensive possession and the disappointment of a missed opportunity on that deep ball from Masoli to Ackland. As here you see the concentration from Shaq Johnson. As Masoli, I talked about that accuracy in the pregame show. How about the way he dropped this one in just inside that sideline to the former BC Lions receiver.
Bahar with 38 yards. Johnson finishes it with 20. A couple of catches for Darvin Adams as Masoli moving the ball around this new look offense in Ottawa. And the extra point is hammered through by Lewis Ward. And we are tied at 7. Johnson finding the end zone. Masoli, his first touchdown pass.
Tap on it on the base of the Grey Cup. It is 33 diamonds to signify the 33 points that they had. But this is what I love most, with the attention to detail that they had on this ring. But how about this? Etched on the side, it was a picture taken last year of fans in the stands. Fans are often talked about by this team about how much they mean to it. We know the atmosphere that's here, and they wanted it to be represented. This is one of the most beautiful rings that I have seen. I cannot guarantee that you will see me after this, because I might run off with it, and I might have a few people chasing me as well.
Well, nice knowing you, Sarah.
You may think that that ring looked big because of the size of Sarah's hands, but Sarah actually has huge hands. Massive.
Massive.
So, yeah, so that tells you how big the ring actually is.
That's Janarian Grant on the return. Takes it out to about the 35-yard line for the Bombers. And good reputation. I mean, the party was started here a little early today, I'll say that. But, hey, when you're back-to-back champs, you got something to cheer about.
Lots to cheer about, yeah. And I mean, you talk about the fans in Winnipeg. This certainly is a great atmosphere. Investors Group Field, I know we talked before this game. We're always working when we're here, but we were looking down at the pregame crowd thinking it would be kind of fun to be part of that, joining the action.
It honestly looks like a really good time. They hand it off to Johnny Augustine as he gets involved in the offense. And we're going to see the Bombers use both of these guys throughout the season.
Yeah, no question. Understandable that it would take more than one person to attempt to replace Andrew Harris. It'll be by committee with these two guys, both with some experience in the Canadian Football League now, and both have enjoyed some success here as well.
We'll see which one of them can master the old Harris spin, right? A little bit of contact and spin off. Did that for a few years here. Four receivers to the left for Kolaris. Second and 10. He's second and six. He's facing right now. And that one into traffic again. He was looking for Wolitarski, but it was neatly batted down by Baltimore for the REDBLACKS.
And it looked like Wolitarski kind of turned DB on this one as Baltimore had him shielded out from the football. You see Wolitarski reaching over the back to ensure that that one's not going the other way.
Leggio stands on his own 25. Terry Williams waiting on his 25. Tied at 7. 2.5 minutes to play here. Friday night football opener on TSN. Williams hustles up underneath this one. There is a flag back near the kick. Williams will get it back up to about the 40, where he's gang tackled and taken down. Shaq Johnson, 7 career touchdowns, now 8 with the one here tonight.
With the ball in flight, we have holding Ottawa, number 99. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Take a look, Shaq Johnson, 7 on his career, first as an Ottawa REDBLACK, and the first touchdown pass of Jeremiah Masoli's Ottawa career. Nice placement on that football. Great concentration from Shaq to haul that one in.
Quick drive, just 1:38, 3 plays for 63 yards. The big one to Bahar, really getting them going. And we'll see if Ottawa can silence this crowd here in Winnipeg again. Trips to the right for Masoli. Going to look to his left. Has a completion, but nowhere to go on the play. Kyrie Wilson over there to make the stop. Jackson Bennett getting involved in this offense.
Yeah, Bennett, another former Hamilton Tiger Cat, who's making his way home to Ottawa, former University of Ottawa Gigi. Linebacker DB for the Gigi's, but has made the conversion to running back in the Canadian Football League, and he's a good one.
11th overall pick in 2018. 2nd and 8 now for Masoli. Look to his right. Jefferson took that away from him. Now he's in trouble. Ball bounces up, laying there. And eventually, they're going to just say play is over as the Bombers. That was shades of what we saw from the Bombers defense last year. Masoli was running for his life.
Yeah, initially trying to make something happen and then attempting to cut his losses on this one. Jefferson quick off the ball. As the quarterback gets forced back, he's just trying to get rid of that one to avoid being backed up into his own end zone in a sack situation.
Cedric Wilcox, 93 in blue, was the one who got to him right at the end.
Yeah, Wilcox getting some reps here tonight with Jackson Jeffcoat sidelined. I've seen Jeffcoat on the sidelines coaching up Wilcox and LB Mack, who is in that rotation as well.
Leone gets this away, takes a high bounce just inside the 50. Big time football is back. CFL regular season kickoff continues tomorrow with doubleheader action as the Tiger Cats take on the Rough Riders, followed by a West Division clash between the Elks and the Lions. Tune in at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, only on TSN. Looking forward to being in BC with you tomorrow night. Big concert, huge crowd going to be for that game. Looks pretty exciting. Long way to go on this one, though. Tied at 7, less than a minute to go. Kolaris with 4 receiving options to his left. Comes over the middle. That's another completion, and it's back to Ellingson again. And safe to say, I don't want to jump to conclusions, but he's fitting in pretty well here.
Well, he certainly is. And Greg Ellingson, quick hitter here. You're going to watch the wide side of the field kind of clears out. Kolaris coming back to that backside, trips into the boundary. That time, Ellingson finding his way into an opening.
On the 48, hands it off. Oliveira right up the middle, gets it down to about the 45-yard line. Oliveira, last year, averaged 4.6 yards per carry, had a couple touchdowns, also had a couple of 100-yard games last season, filling in for Andrew Harris. Johnny Augustine, a 100-yard game himself, final game of the year, went off for 148 yards on 23 carries. So both guys certainly have some upside. It's Oliveira who now slides back in behind his quarterback. He'll stay in there to protect. Kolaro stumps it off over the middle, and that one is complete. Levels with the tackle at the end of the play. And an excellent first quarter to get us started here on Friday Night Football for the 2022 CFL season. Both teams finding the end zone. Ellingson for the Bombers. Mazzoli, like, getting their offense going a little bit there.
Yeah, missed opportunity early on as Mazzoli looked deep for Acklin, but I thought the Red Blacks responded very well. Again, they had Winnipeg had just scored, and you never know, right? Winnipeg, a tough team to play against here in the Peg. But Ottawa holding their own in the early going, no doubt.
Everybody on Ottawa's offense is new, but the new guy on Winnipeg, Greg Ellingson, really stepping up there, getting involved in that first quarter. We'll see how that connection continues to work. Thank you very much for joining us here. Beautiful night in Winnipeg. Leggio. Last year, his long was 50. He was 5 of 8, 62.5% on the field goals. And this one is bobbled by Pukop. Now he's going to turn around and run it. He can certainly do this. He cuts it back up, and guess what? He's got a first down. Not how they drew it up.
Exactly how they drew it up.
But it worked out anyway.
A great reaction here from Dakota Pukop. The benefit of having a guy with some experience, not to mention athletic ability, in that position as the holder. Couldn't handle it cleanly, but quick reaction to scoop it up, and shows that elusiveness that he's always possessed as something of a scrambling quarterback to turn this into a first down for the Bombers.
Now get their offense back out on the field.
Lemons, lemonade, Dustin.
That's what you make out of them, right? Is that what it is? Turns out this ball will be on the Ottawa 34.
Well, Cleon Lang shaken up slightly, as you see Ottawa defensive coordinator Mike Benavides.
What a stash.
The outlaw, Mike Benavides.
First and 10 now. Second crack at it here for Winnipeg. Kolaris complete. Bailey, I believe, inside the 20, and he's fired up for his first catch of the season.
And Rashid Bailey is one of the guys that they'll be counting on heavily this season. We've seen, obviously, Greg Ellingson added to that receiving corps, but with Kenny Lawler and Darvin Adams moving on, Rashid Bailey is a young man who's expected to take a big leap forward here in 22.
Fresh set of downs from the Ottawa 19. Oliveira on the handoff, and ouch, you could hear that one from up here. He gets absolutely popped by Avery Williams, who had 89 tackles last season.
Yeah, Avery Williams, something of a tackling machine from that middle linebacker position, where you see him in between the goalposts. Flowing, filling, beats the block to make the play. Frankie Griffin in there as well.
Polaris to his right, some pressure coming, gets it away, almost sidearm, and he finds Ellingson again. It's fourth catch of the game for Greg Ellingson.
And again, no surprise that Greg Ellingson would be something of a security blanket for Zach Kolaros.
Was not enough for the first down, so they will bring it out and try it again. This time, much easier attempt for Leggio. Both he and Mortada having a pretty good camp for the Bombers. Leggio gets the job to start the season. 20-yard field goal attempt here, and he does knock it home. And the Winnipeg Blue Bombers go back on top. Off the leg of Leggio, they lead 10-7. Mazzoli put on a little bit of a show here in the first quarter, finding Johnson for a touchdown. Now he's going to look down the field again, and this is another deep ball that is complete, taken all the way down inside the 20 as he is moving it well, and this time he goes to Dubois.
Yeah, Marco Dubois listed as a fullback. This is a guy who was a receiver and primarily special teams player. Lines up as a tight end on this play, but primarily a special teamer and receiver coming out of college at Laval. Gets the jump from that tight end spot where I think he caught Winston Rose anticipating that he would be used in more of a blocking role on that play.
54-yard pickup for Dubois. Mazzoli's at 126 yards and a touchdown. Hands this one off to Williams, who picks his way through that defense down to the 10. That's some hard running from Devontae Williams.
Yeah, nice run there, making a couple miss, beating a couple of other tackles to pick up positive yardage here. Nice cut right at the point of attack. Second and short here for the REDBLACKS.
All that police watching on has to like what he's seeing from his new quarterback. Second and four for Mazzoli. Pressure coming this time. Had to get rid of it. And he did, but it does fall incomplete on the second down as he tried to get it to Justin Hardy for the first time tonight.
And you're going to see the pressure coming from the secondary here, trying to time this one up right off the edge. Mazzoli sees it coming, but still can't quite get rid of that ball fast enough. And you can see pressure coming off both edges, so he can't really roll to the side that he's throwing to, because he'd be running into pressure on that side. So he's just got to get rid of it as fast as he can.
Lewis Ward now to tie this game. And he knocks it home, and we are deadlocked once again. Ottawa, this new-look REDBLACKS team, hanging tough with the two-time champs. Now we've got Friday Night Football trivia. There's the question. Who scored the first TD in Friday Night Football history?
You can tweet your responses, by the way, to Rod Smith and Glenn Suter.
They'll love it. Kolaris now, ooh, able to dump it off to Oliveira, who now takes it down to the 45. He's popped there. It's levels again, lowering the boom. Going to work with Howell on the play.
Oh, purely ad-lib here for Kolaris. He's just trying to buy time. He knows he's got Oliveira there as an outlet. He'll slip out to the left side of your screen. With pressure in his face, unable to get the ball downfield, he dumps it off. Oliveira may be wishing he hadn't.
He's got two catches. He's carried the ball six times as well. So certainly involved in this offense for Winnipeg with Andrew Harris no longer around. Kolaris, empty backfield this time. Oliveira again, but that one is high over his head. Kind of turned him around a little bit, and it will fall incomplete. That'll bring up third and five for the Bombers.
Well, here's a look at the dynamic duo at running back for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers to open the season. You see their numbers from 2021. Both these guys getting reasonable workload in that backfield last year and proving to be productive.
Leggio kicks it away. This ball is going to bounce and bounce and bounce eventually out of bounds. Here's our answer for Friday Night Football trivia. I was thinking pinball. But it's not pinball.
Robert Drummond.
See that dance?
That was 1997.
Yeah. That was big back then? I think he's a two-time All-Star. Everybody got in.
You want to know how time has passed? You saw there Adrian Smith joining in the celebration. His son Keandre was drafted this year.
So I guess it has been 25 years is what you're saying.
Yes. Time marches on. It's been a generation of Friday Night Football.
Jesse Briggs, the injured Bomber, down on the field. Try to find a look, see what happened.
Briggs, Canadian linebacker, BC native, who played his college football at McGill, an important part of the Bombers' special teams, but guy who was very productive last year, making some starts at the weak side linebacker spot for them.
Had a touchdown last year. I think it was a scoop and score in Toronto, I believe. And he's able to walk off on his own, so that's nice to see. First and 10 here for the Ottawa after that kick. First and 10 on the Ottawa 11. Mazzoli with 125 yards already. He's got another completion. This is to Hardy. Hardy lowered his shoulder to pick up a few extra yards, and the former longtime Atlanta Falcon is able to get involved in the offense now.
Yeah, Hardy was one of the wild cards in that receiver competition in training camp. You know, a lot of names and faces familiar to CFL fans brought in. We've talked about Jalen Acklin, Darvin Adams. BJ Cunningham was also in camp from Ottawa, released at the end of camp. They had RJ Harris, Ryan Davis as holdovers from last year.
That handoff will go for a first down.
Shaq Johnson, of course, another of the newcomers with a touchdown here tonight. Some guys who bring some experience, bring some numbers with them. You know, particularly when you look at Darvin Adams' body of work and his familiarity with the Paul LaPolice offense. Jalen Acklin, of course, a young guy who's just entering his prime in the Canadian Football League.
There's a completion to Adams, and that timed out well. Adams, since in the last 5 years, has had almost 4,000 receiving yards, sixth most in the entire league over the last five seasons.
Yeah, there are certain names, right, you get used to seeing on the leaderboard every year, and Darvin Adams, since moving to Winnipeg from Toronto, had been one of those guys.
Second and three on the 30. Near side, it's Hardy. It's complete, and it's enough for another Ottawa first down.
Darvin Adams, a couple of 1,000-yard seasons with Winnipeg.
Yeah, here he is, as most in the stands here tonight remember him in blue and gold, making big plays. Over 300 catches as a Winnipeg Blue Bomber for Darvin Adams.
Two catches with Ottawa so far here tonight. Mazzoli, far side. That's another completion. And trying to push ahead, he was held onto and stuffed there was Jalen Acklin. But Acklin gets his first catch of the ball game.
Jalen Acklin, second on the Hamilton Tiger Cats in receiving last year after an outstanding rookie campaign in 2019 for the Ticats. Kind of made the move last year in part due to early season injuries for the Ticats, from playing primarily out wide to playing a lot in the slot. And obviously, big part of his development as a receiver, getting to move around a little bit, be more involved in the game plan.
Short yardage, Evans in the game, trying to just lunge ahead right over the pile. And it'll be close. It's back to Acklin quickly. He was targeted at least 70 times in both of his seasons in Hamilton. You knew some brilliance was coming. He was an all-star last year. Ottawa's getting just 26 years old, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And not a surprise with Sean Burke taking over as the general manager in Ottawa, moving over from the Ticats organization. Burkey with a terrific reputation as kind of a player's guy in the front office, so not surprising to see a number of individuals, Mazzoli and Acklin among them, follow him east.
They're going to go for it on third and inches, pushing ahead again. Flags on both sides of the field. A little bit of a better push this time around for the 23-year-old Caleb Evans.
Offside, Winnipeg, defensive line. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Yeah, there you can see a few hands over the line into that neutral zone.
First time that Winnipeg has been penalized in this game. Pretty much right at midfield here. Ball on the Ottawa 54 for Jeremiah Mazzoli. Down the field is where he's going to go. And that one a little too far for the intended target, Justin Hardy.
Well, Ottawa has certainly not lacked for aggressiveness in the first half of this ball game. Mazzoli taking a few shots downfield. You see Hardy again using that waggle to attack the defenders, get on top of them, but a nice job there.
Looked like Mazzoli wanted to let it go a little bit earlier, but some pressure there from Ricky Walker changed the plan. Second and 10 on his own 54. Big Hill's going to bring a little bit of pressure. Mazzoli's got to get rid of it, dumps it off underneath. That'll be caught by Williams, but he's stopped in his tracks, tripped up by Kyrie Wilson.
And this is a fantastic defensive play from Kyrie Wilson. He sniffs out the play. He's trying to get to the back in coverage. Two blockers get on top of him and are basically grabbing the Bomber linebacker. He's right on the hash mark. He'll come from the left side of your screen. Fights through that block of two defenders. There you see him split it. Two blockers to come through and make the play. Great effort from Wilson.
Leone lets it go from about his own 45. Grant's trying to hustle over there. It's going to bounce over his head. And he will grab it there and take a knee. Well, the chirps are coming out on a Friday night. Both sides fired up.
Well, Dustin, we always hear every year it's a new team, regardless of how many returning players there are. But as you and Dwayne have spoken about, I mean, there's been so many new faces over here for the Ottawa Redblacks that team chemistry was something that Paul Appelis really wanted to emphasize throughout training camp. And in order to do that, he went old school. How about this? He had them doing water balloon fights, offensive line, defensive line, catching punts, a movie night at the stadium on the scoreboard. And then my personal favorite, a very heated battle of rock, paper, scissors, which you and I are having. Third, potentially fourth quarter, you and Dwayne are going down.
Oh, man, rock, paper, scissors is usually something you do when you want to get out of something.
Yeah.
Right? Like, oh, no, you lose, you got to go. Right. It's unique ways to bring teams together, though, right?
Let me just say, challenge accepted, Oreski. Yeah.
He's in trouble this time. Dumps it off over the middle. It's going to be almost intercepted. Oh, my. In and out of the hands of Money Hunter. Looked like he had it. Looked like he was going to go. And it slipped out before he could bring it in for full control of that ball. Zach Kolaris dodging a little bit of a bullet right here. Hunter steps underneath Schoen, almost took that thing away.
Leverages as a corner guy. Winston Rose in trouble.
Trouble.
What the hell, man?
Outside 13 seconds. Let's go.
Yeah, I got a little Kolaris Nelly action.
Mazzoli dropping dimes. That's it, baby.
Nice. 3 seconds to spare. That's teamwork right here.
Nowhere to go. On that return, here's another look. Ooh.
Yeah, good anticipation, nice break to the ball. Just couldn't quite finish. And we know the consequences for dropping balls.
Push-ups. Is that Baltimore doing it with him?
That's a good teammate.
That is a great teammate. Or somebody who just loves doing push-ups. 2:37 remaining here in the first half. Mazzoli gonna hand this one off. And that is pushed ahead nicely by Bennett. Ottawa on the road with a lead against the Bombers. Mazzoli 10 of 15 for a $1.59 and a touchdown.
Well, we saw the stats on the frequency with which Jeremiah Mazzoli throws for over 300, and he is on pace here in the first half.
8 different receivers for Mazzoli have caught a pass tonight. Now he's going to look down the field. This one might be a little bit too far. Picked off, but there's a flag just inside the 45. Tyquan Glass came up with it. He's going to drop it back now to Nick Taylor. Taylor up the far sideline, and he'll take it down inside the thing sorted out with just under 2 minutes to play.
And given the location of that flag.
Pass interference, Winnipeg, number 22. Spot of the foul, first down.
And keep an eye on the matchup on the outside here. That's Tyquan Glass in coverage. That corner. Knew he was caught on that double move by Acklin, had to grab to recover.
Glass coming from Montreal. Was in Edmonton the year before. Another handoff to Bennett, and another decent pickup on first down.
Well, Jackson Bennett had a terrific touchdown run in the first preseason game against Toronto. As we take a look here at the work of the Bomber or the Red Blacks' new offensive line. Hunter Stewart at left guard, right at the point of attack on that one.
The only returning member on that line is Dino Boyd. He only played 3 games in 2021. Empty backfield this time. Jefferson in the face of Mazzoli. Mazzoli gets it away. And that is complete on the near side of the field. Acklin went down to get it. And he's awfully close to a fresh set of downs. They're going to give it to him.
Well, watch the timing of two things on this play. First, the timing of the get off by Willie Jefferson. So quick. And then Jeremiah Masoli, recognizing that because he has to throw the ball early, puts a little more arc on it than he normally would on that quick out to Acklin. Ball's thrown earlier, so he's going to have it take a little bit more time to get to the spot.
It's only Whelan and Dylan here in his first half with Ottawa. Another completion. When you got guys making catches for you like that, and Darvin Adams, it's certainly going to help.
And again, going back to pregame, and I talked a little bit about the accuracy of Jeremiah Masoli, and there are obviously other factors that contribute to a quarterback's accuracy rating. One of them obviously being the receivers making plays, another one being the protection, reducing the amount of pressure on the quarterback. Ottawa did a great job in the offseason of addressing and upgrading in both those areas as well, putting Masoli in a good position to succeed.
Second and a yard. And a good job cutting it back up the field there by Evans, and that'll be a first down, and Masoli will hustle back out here with less than a minute to play.
Get a look here at clock management down the stretch for the Red Blacks.
Masoli at 174 yards and a touchdown so far here tonight. Now working from the Winnipeg 46. Near side of the field, he's got a completion again. It's Adams again. That's his fourth catch of the ball game.
Yeah, I think Darvin Adams might have been hearing it a little bit from some of his former teammates after this catch right in front of the Winnipeg bench. This touchdown just inbounds.
Adams giving it back.
Put it down. Once again. Hey.
And it will be inches on second down. Dietrich Nichols now wearing number one in this Bombers defense after an excellent season last year, bursting onto the scene here in Winnipeg.
Well, that great combination of Dietrich Nichols and DeAndre Alford, two rookies playing on the boundary side in that secondary, and such an important part of Winnipeg's success last season. Alford, of course, pursuing some NFL opportunities at this time. Nichols carrying on as one of the anchors. The Bomber secondary. There you see Jackson Jeffcoat not playing tonight as he's a little bit nicked up, but he has been busy coaching on the sidelines, giving a lot of feedback to the rest of the D linemen.
Huge.
Every time they come over.
Huge year last year, 9 sacks, playing opposite Willie Jefferson, and then of course the defensive player of the year, Adam Bighill, right in behind him. Evans keeps it again, and he's doing his job on this drive as he pushes it ahead and will get a first down for Ottawa as the clock ticks down to 17 seconds.
And a lot of credit given by Jeremiah Masoli to this young man, Caleb Evans, for helping Masoli get comfortable with some of the concepts in the Ottawa offense, some of the things that they did last year as he finds himself learning a new playbook, working with a new coordinator after several years with Tommy Condell in Hamilton.
Clock ticks down. Masoli has a completion. That'll be taken down inside the 15 by Acklin, but there is no time on the clock for Ottawa. And an excellent, excellent first half comes to a close with the Ottawa Redblacks on the road and on top. They lead 11-10 against the Winnipeg Blue Bombers of Friday Night Football for this 25th anniversary season. And the Ottawa Redblacks, I think we've learned in one half, this is a completely different offense than we saw last year.
Yeah, and it's not just the names that are different. Obviously, the results, the appearance, the efficiency, all making the immediate upgrades made in the offseason very apparent.
Four different receivers with at least 38 yards receiving from Jeremiah Mazzoli, who's over 200 yards with a touchdown already in this game. Terry Williams with some speed. Nice little spin move, stays on his feet. There's a flag back at about the 31. That was a nice burst there from Williams. And here is Jeremiah Mazzoli, who's fitting in pretty darn well so far.
We'll take a look at some of his first 30 minutes of work as an Ottawa Red Black.
During the return,
no hesitation to push that ball down the field.
Number 36, 10-yard penalty.
Taking a few deep shots, and there's a touchdown pass to Shaq Johnson.
The deepest shot he took was dropped by Ackland, or else those numbers would be even bigger.
Yeah, series earlier in the first quarter.
So no hesitation from Mazzoli to move this ball down the field, and we'll see what type of adjustments Bombers defense can put together here in the second half. Two more games coming your way tomorrow night with the CFL on TSN. I'll hand it off to Devontae Williams, and he's wrapped up as he gets back towards the line of scrimmage.
Kyrie Wilson continues to produce. This is the guy who made his way onto the roster initially as a designated import, designated American player, playing a lot on special teams. He's really established himself as a high-level linebacker in this league.
Second and 10 from Mazzoli. Steps up in the pocket. Little spin move, trying to burst ahead. There is a flag behind him as he took it up to about the 25. Nice explosive burst there from Mazzoli. Willie Jefferson trying to get the crowd into this thing.
Holding, Ottawa, number 61. That penalty is declined. Third down.
Keep an eye here. The left tackle, Yukumbre Williams, working against Willie Jefferson. Caught off guard by that quick inside move by Willie J.
A little jersey tug.
Yeah. Whatever it takes to protect your quarterback in that situation.
Noni kicks it away. Grant takes it. Oh, there's only 36. Trying to get towards the near side of the field, but he is stopped. Nowhere to cut back on that play. Blue Bombers trailing by a point at home in their opener.
So Darvin Adams appeared quite a bit, so a lot of the new players were able to see what Darvin was able to do. And as for Greg Ellingson, again, veteran leadership when he comes in here. You think about all of the 1,000-yard receiving seasons that he had. A great weapon for Zach Kolaris. He said, with their chemistry going back to the Hamilton days, we've seen early on this could be a great pairing.
Well, it sure looks like that so far. Quick handoff on the play, but here's a look at what Ellingson has done in his career.
And Ellingson alluding a little earlier to those, the history with Zach Kolaris. Teammates briefly, really, 2014 in Hamilton. The two of them were together. Kolaris having come over from Toronto as a free agent that year. It was Ellingson's second year in the league. He moved on to Ottawa the next year as a free agent.
Back to Augustine again, and that's not going to go anywhere. Here's some, here's a look at his early work here with the Bombers.
Yeah, a veteran receiver who just knows where he needs to be at a given time, a knack for finding openings, deceptively fast as well, so an ability to work and get open against man coverage. As I called him earlier, quarterback's best friend, very reliable guy. Guy who kind of understands the game from the quarterback's perspective and where his QB needs him to be at any given time.
33-year-old had five straight 1,000-yard seasons from 2015 to 2019. Williams slides under this just inside his own 30. And they'll sort out a couple of flags as we take a look at Darvin Adams returning to play against a team he had so much success with.
Yeah, you mentioned it earlier. Dustin Darvin Adams. Over 4,000 yards as a Winnipeg Blue Bomber. Six seasons there, a couple of thousand yard receiving seasons for Adams. But, you know, a guy who had really, especially in his early years in Winnipeg, kind of came to establish himself as a go-to guy there. And I think brought along the rest of that receiving corps, allowing younger guys like Kenny Lawler and Rasheed Bailey to start to step up a little bit.
Both Ellingson and Adams in this game, if you can believe it, four catches for 38 yards, each of them. Here's Mazzoli now. Pressure. Nice move to stay on his feet, get out of the pocket, look down the field. And that is batted away by Nichols after an excellent effort by Mazzoli to keep that play alive.
Yeah, this was a great escape move from Jeremiah Mazzoli. He thought he was going to spin right back into pursuit here. Just worked his way out of it. Nichols really just picking up where he left off in his freshman Canadian Football League season. Making a big play there along the sideline.
Three interceptions in his first year. Seven knockdowns as well. Got himself an all-star nod. And I think he was number 34 in our TSN top 50 players coming into the season. Mazzoli now. No time again. Down the field, and Darvin Adams says, I got it. He goes back to get it, and he's able to hang on.
Yeah, great fundamental play there from Darvin Adams, working back towards his quarterback along the sideline. The max protection look here from Ottawa. Mazzoli drifts right to buy time. Adams coming back to the ball to help out his QB.
13 more yards for Adams, puts him at 51 in the game. Four receivers to the left for Mazzoli. They'll hand it off. Williams spins his way for about half of what they need on first down. His sixth carry of the ball game.
Winnipeg was looking to bring a little bit of pressure off the edge that time. Ottawa catches them in the blitz and turns that into a nice first down game.
Jeremiah Mazzoli, best season of his career. You got to go back to 2018. 5,200 yards and 28 touchdowns. A sensational season in Hamilton. Just getting started here in Ottawa. Far side of the field. And that is a completion as well. Back to Johnson, who had a touchdown earlier in the game.
Yeah, Shaq Johnson, the former BC Lion. As Ottawa starts two Canadians in that receiving corps, Johnson, Nate Bahar. We saw Bahar with kind of the first big catch of the game for Ottawa to get things going, set the table for Johnson's TD.
His only catch of the game, but it went for 38 yards for Bahar. Mazzoli in trouble again, escapes again, at least for a moment, and then he is wrapped up and taken down as they get home on the Ottawa quarterback.
I'm intrigued by this young man, Donald Rutledge Jr., number 38. He's right on the edge of the formation here. He's the nickel linebacker. You know, we think of that as a DB position. And sometimes you see smaller guys playing that spot. Now, Rutledge is a guy, who, a college DB, but a bigger body. You know, and I think that that sometimes equips him a little bit better to defend the run, but also to be involved in that blitz scheme at the line of scrimmage, fighting through about 6'2", 215, goes Rutledge.
Second and 20, a ton of time for Mazzoli, near sideline, and he's got a completion for a first down to Jalen Acklin.
Get an indication of how open Acklin was on this play by how long this ball sat up in the air. We take a look at the all-24 camera. There's Acklin to the bottom of your screen at that wideout spot. He's going to push upfield. It's just going to hang out on the sidelines. Long throw.
Come on back here.
Yeah, Masoli calling his shot over there.
Hand off to Williams this time for a couple of yards.
And there you see Rutledge in again, defending the run.
I thought Rutledge listed at 6'1", but he looks a little bit bigger than that, doesn't he?
He does.
I've twice now, I've looked down, I'm like, are we sure he's 6'1"?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going ahead and giving him at least 6'2".
Yeah. You got the good eyes up here. Second and 8 for Mazzoli. More pressure from the Bombers. Gets it away, and he's got another complete pass. Back to Adams, who signals a first down.
Darvin Adams this time working out of the number 2 slot in that 3 receiver formation to the wider side of the field.
Great shot of Adams in the new colors. Mazzoli at 266 yards midway through the third quarter. One is batted down at the line of scrimmage.
Keep an eye on Willie Jefferson, left side of your screen. Zoli's looking that way, but as he does so often, Willie Jefferson gets those big long arms up in front of the ball.
2 interceptions last year for him, 5 knockdowns as well. This is the 10th play of this drive for the REDBLACKS. Mazzoli running away from Jefferson right up the middle. And eventually Willie is there to finish him off after he was slowed down along the way.
Yeah, it's a great effort by Casey Sales, who reaches back as Mazzoli sees. Watch again the quick get off from Willie Jefferson. Doing such a good job of anticipating those snap counts. Ottawa is going to need to make sure they're mixing those up. Jefferson is tough enough to handle when he's not, he doesn't have his timing as perfect as it has been today.
Lewis Ward, almost 90% in his career. Now 2 for 2 tonight. And the REDBLACKS lead now sits at 14-10 in Winnipeg. Tomorrow with third round coverage as the best in golf tee off from St. George's Golf and Country Club. TSN has exclusive tournament coverage all week. Tune in at 3 Eastern, noon Pacific to catch the action. See how I say that low key? That's my golf voice. That's my golf voice.
Very good, as we see Jackson Jeffcoat doing a little coaching on the sidelines.
Kolaris takes the handoff. Has a man wide open. It's Ellingson again, and that'll go for a first down, and then he's hammered from behind. Nowhere else to go. Well, there was some pressure coming there on Kolaris, and he was able to find Ellingson.
We talked about a receiver knowing where he needs to be for his quarterback, and you see the veteran timing here from quarterback Zach Kolaris. He knows Ellingson's going to get to the middle. He's got to take a little bit of a leap of faith here as he puts this ball in the air. Ellingson gets to the spot to pick up that first down.
5th catch of the game for Ellingson. Kolaris now to his right. And that is batted down. There is a flag, maybe a little bit of a late flag coming in there. And Justin Howell turns around and says, it wasn't me. Haven't seen a lot of Kolaris lately. The REDBLACKS have had the ball and been on the field quite a bit since the end of the first quarter.
Pass interference, Ottawa, number 21. Spot of the foul, first down.
He's just wrapped up his arms entirely, yeah. Couldn't make a play on it.
Yeah, that's a tough call for me.
Looking for Dembski, who has just one catch for 7 yards so far this evening. Winnipeg from the Ottawa 45, down by 4. Late third quarter, Kolaris underneath for Dembski. Read well by the Red Blacks. And Dembski gets maybe a yard. Huge season last year for Nick Dembski. 40 catches, 654 yards. Found the end zone. Had a 100-yard game as well. Second and 9. Far side completion, ball pop. Oh, it's a helmet that came flying out. Ball pop loose as well. Baltimore's got it. It was into the hands of Dalton Schoen, and we'll have to get another look at this one.
Yeah, Schoen took a big shot.
The ruling on the field is a fumble recovered by Ottawa.
Oh boy.
See, as Schoen catches this one, sorry, outside receiver there as he's being spun to the turf. Just gets the helmet rocked off his head.
It was Howell who had him, wrapped him up. He'd just taken that pass interference penalty. So a little redemption here for Howell. And the ball ruled the Red Blacks. Ottawa Red Blacks have the ball after this fumble by Dalton Schoen. There's the ball that comes loose. He gets popped. And then the ball is laying there, and Baltimore is able to hop on top of it. So the Red Blacks defense making a big play here.
Yes, sir. Leading the takeaway.
Mazzoli. Low snap. Picks it up. Now he's going to look down the field, and that one falls incomplete. Looking for Hardy and missed him a little bit. It was neat Nichols in coverage there.
Yeah, it seemed like Mazzoli might have been a little locked in on going deep, predetermined on the deep shot on that one. Is Nichols
after the turnover?
Yeah. Yeah, the sudden change. Nichols in good position all the way on that one.
Second and 10 now. Crowd starting to get behind this Bombers defense at IG Field. Mazzoli from his own 34. He's going to look down the field again. This one's up for grabs, and it's going to be picked off. Nick Taylor answers back, and the Bombers defense goes and gets the ball. A fumble at one end, an interception at the other. Comes up with it. Nick Taylor did not have an interception last year. He's got the third of his career here tonight.
Yeah, it looked like he may have been turned around a little bit initially on this route by Justin Hardy. But the ball thrown a little bit to the outside there by Jeremiah Mazzoli allows Taylor to go make a play.
Kolaris gets the ball back. Now he's going to look down the field, and that one falls incomplete in the direction of Drew Wolitarski. So both quarterbacks just taking shot after shot after shot here.
So you say you want more offense.
Here you go.
Let's go. I feel like there should be a starter's pistol instead of a cadence.
Kolaris is 13 of 17 for 128 and a touchdown. Mazzoli 266, touchdown and a pick. About 2 minutes remaining here in the third quarter. Empty backfield, Kolaris in trouble. Almost threw that one away. excellent job, I think, by his receiver coming back, Bailey, to make sure that wasn't intercepted.
Yeah, and that one, the trajectory of the ball was impacted as Kolaris got hit just as he steps up to throw this football. The pocket kind of closes down on him.
Bryant knocked back into him there. Frankie Griffin, who almost had a shot at it until Bailey came back and interfered. Maggio kicks it away. Williams hustles over there as this one will bounce out of bounds. 95 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Mazzoli and his Redblacks on top by four.
We'll take a look back at Mazzoli's last pass. Intended for Justin Hardy.
What do you think Jake Thomas had to say there?
I'm going to speculate that that there wasn't a lot of trash talk from Jake Thomas. He was just ready to block. Fingertape on the non-throwing hand there from Mazzoli.
No need to panic. Hand it off. And nowhere to go that time for Jackson Bennett. Bombers defense keeping this one possession game.
Yeah, looking to tighten things up here, maybe get their offense a short field if they can create a quick two and out here against Paul LaPolice's offense. Lapo with his first trip back to Winnipeg since departing to become the head coach in Ottawa after the 19 season.
Mazzoli near side, and that one will fall incomplete as well, looking for Johnson. These two teams haven't played in 1,056 days, if you're wondering why Lapo hadn't come back.
Yeah, they didn't meet last season. You see Bomber defense starting to heat up a little bit and getting after the Ottawa QB.
Leone stands just inside his own 15. Just got it away. Grant Waite for it at the 40. Up the sideline, a flag after a return.
Penalty, first down.
It'll be backed up here after the return by Grant. Look at that Bombers offensive line. Hardrick, Neufeld, Couture, Bryant, and Jeff Gray sliding in there this year. Eighth overall pick in 2017 was Gray.
In terms of depth, starting the season on the injured list, the Bombers also have their 2021 first rounder, Liam Dobson.
Handoff stuffed immediately. 7th carry of the game for Oliveira. And that is going to bring us to the end of the third quarter. Jeremiah Mazzoli going to work, 266 yards and a touchdown, but most importantly, Redblacks leading 14-10. Everyone, and it's the visitors with a little bit of a surprising lead here on the defending champions, 14-10. Look at those passing yards, 266. I guess it was a good decision to bring in Jeremiah Mazzoli.
Yeah, well, I mean, it was the obvious upgrade, the obvious starting point, and I think that other pieces fell into place around it, and you're getting an idea why. I mean, when you get into a situation like Ottawa was in free agency, everybody is going to ask the first question, even guys on the defensive side of the ball, before they were going to commit to signing in Ottawa, their first question, who's your quarterback going to be? right? Defensive guys want to know that they're not going to be out on the field for 35 minutes a yeah. night. You know, and then offensive linemen are, you know, they want to know who's behind them. Receivers want to know who's throwing them the ball. Jeremiah Masoli is the key to the rebuild here.
Here's Kolaris. He's got Bailey. Bailey, nice move. Hesitation, cuts it inside and tracked down from behind. Pretty good effort there from Bailey. But it won't be enough.
Yeah, and we expect a big 2022 season from Rashid Bailey, a guy who had some very high highs in that Bomber receiving corps a year ago.
Winnipeg, four drives here in the second half, three of them two and outs. And now this kick out of play at the 43 of Ottawa.
And there you see the impact that Willie Jefferson has had in his two seasons as a Bomber, but I'm not sure that the numbers even tell the complete story. You know, when you think about the role that Jefferson and his presence have played, I think, in the development of Jackson Jeffcoat into a premier pass rusher in this league as well. You've got a guy like Willie Jefferson playing off and opposite. You're drawing some attention, but also setting a standard.
Another completion for Masoli back to Shaq Johnson.
You know, we've seen it for a number of years over the career of Charleston Hughes, right? I looked at it a couple of years ago. I think it was eight consecutive years that whoever played opposite Charleston Hughes set a career high in sacks. And it was a number of different guys, obviously, that rolled through there. And you see some of those guys now sort of building their own legacy. You talk about Willie Jefferson, Jagarrett Davis.
Evans, the keeper. Needed the 53.
Watch Darvin Adams towards the top of your screen here. Looked like he might have gotten his foot stomped on there. The short yardage play came up hobbling.
And this is a tight one, so they're going to measure this. Adams targeted eight times tonight. Caught six of them for 63 yards. Acklin targeted six times, and he's caught four of them. Eight different receivers have caught at least one ball from Jeremiah Masoli. And I guess when you're trying to make a new offense gel, not a bad idea to get literally everybody involved.
Yeah. Yeah. And when you think about Paul LaPolice during his time coordinating the offense in Winnipeg, and that was certainly one of the hallmarks, spreading that rock around.
First and 10, handoff to Williams. Got bumped at the line of scrimmage, but still pushed ahead for a pretty good pickup on first down.
Masoli with just trying to hold that defense with a little hitch screen fake on the back end of that after the handoff.
Williams was on the practice roster of the Bombers. Was released last September. Found his way to Ottawa. Five targets to the right for Masoli. He's going to look over the middle. And that is a completion where the price was paid by Bahar.
Yeah, Adam Big Hill sending a little reminder that he's still here.
You don't come over the middle yeah. against me, right?
Good job by Bahar to hold on as he got rocked there.
Third and short. Evans to keep this drive alive for Ottawa. Big play here. This will be interesting to see where the ball is spotted.
A nice second effort here from the second year Ottawa quarterback Caleb Evans. Big hill over the top. Shane Gauthier off the edge, stopping his initial momentum. We'll see if this spin is enough.
But this ball is spotted. It's going to be tight.
I think he's down before he reaches that ball out. And I think from that angle, it looked like he was short. Adam Big Hill and other members of the Bomber defense are already over on the sidelines. Their minds made up.
Bombers defense does it again. Turnover on downs. And their offense, down four, will have the ball when we return. It is a beautiful night.
I don't know that tarps should be optional for everybody, but
fully agree.
Discuss amongst yourselves.
Schoen with the catch. Nice pickup of about 8 or 9 there on first down.
Yeah, solid protection, quick hitter before the unblocked man.
They're excited about this guy.
Yeah, Dalton Schoen. Rookie earning a starting job in that receiving core. A guy who Mike O'Shea describes as kind of mature beyond his years in terms of his preparation. You know, first year guy who thinks, works, acts like a professional.
It was a walk-on at Kansas State. Rukop looking for that first down marker. Looks like he was going to be stopped short.
Look right down the line, shows Patrick Levels holding Prukop up just short of that first down marker.
And that'll bring up third and short. So an opportunity here for the REDBLACKS defense to return the favor. Third and inches, Prukop trying to push ahead. Like where he came up off the ground, he had enough, and he does. And Winnipeg's offense remains on the field with 9:17 left to go in the ball game. Found a nice spot in behind the big guys on the right side of that offensive line. ...142 yards for Kolaris. He's going to turn around and hand this ball off. And that'll likely go for a loss on the play. Not a lot has opened up here tonight for Oliveira.
No, you've got to give a lot of credit to this Ottawa defense. You know, I mean, the Winnipeg run game certainly was not just Andrew Harris. We talked about Oliveira and Johnny Augustine, both having 100-yard games themselves last season. This is a terrific Winnipeg offensive line. Very consistent, very productive when you look at the last couple of years. So to limit them in the run game is a coup.
Pressure coming. Kolaris gets away. He's got a man down the field wide open. And that's going to be complete for a big one. He finds Dalton Schoen. Hangs on for the first down.
A nice execution under pressure here from Zach Kolaris and the Winnipeg Blue Bombers offense. Steps up to avoid that initial blitz. And Schoen settles down, sort of throttles down as he finds himself in an open window to connect with his quarterback.
Now they'll get it into the hands of Dembski. Dembski inside the 20, forced out of bounds before he could get to the 15 with 7:32 on the clock.
And suddenly the Bombers' offense comes to life and elicits a little bit of a response from the crowd here as well. You see them clear things out in front. Ellingson basically just delaying until that ball has been thrown before he can block on that bubble screen.
Third catch of the game for Dembski. 8 yards is what they got. Second and two. Prukop back into the game. Trying to push ahead. Nice burst through there for the first down. Flags on both sides of the field. As Winnipeg marching their way towards that Ottawa end zone.
Absolutely no doubt on that short yardage play.
Offside, Ottawa, defensive line. 5 yard penalty, first down.
That's what he was brought in here to do. Role that McGuire had last year for the Grey Cup champs. First and 10, Ottawa 12 here. Kolaris towards the end zone. Bailey goes up and gets it, hangs on. Stopped just short.
Yeah, Bailey pushed upfield initially into the end zone, then you'll see him work back on the outside to the football here. Just over the goal line, ball thrown to the outside. Nice extension to go up and get that one.
Prukop back in the game. Looking for the lead. Pushing ahead and he stops. Nowhere to go. Flags at the end of it.
Looked almost as if Prukop lost his footing or had his legs
offside,
taken out on his first
Ottawa
step.
Defensive line. First down.
Here's another look at it. Yeah, looked like his upper body kind of got caught on his old line and took his legs out.
Yeah, I think he may have ended up stepping actually on the legs of fallen offensive linemen in front of him.
First and goal again. Dakota Prukop looking to put the Bombers on top. Pushing ahead. Can he get there? Yes! Touchdown, Winnipeg! Prukop finds the end zone.
Surge by the Ottawa defense, but Prukop keeps the legs churning.
Took some extra effort there,
yeah,
didn't it?
Yeah, sure did. Nice job there from the backup quarterback to punch it in.
Leggio will look to put Winnipeg on top by 3. Play 63-yard drive that took 5 minutes and 7 seconds, finished by Prukop. Leggio, and he misses it wide right. This will be brought out of the end zone, and there might be a little bit of room to work here. All the way back to the 20 for Williams, and that's a big miss. Prukop finishes it to put the Bombers on top by just 2. Dakota Prukop, short yardage specialist this year for Winnipeg. The guy who was here before him did a very good job of it. Wearing that same number 12. Leggio to kick it away after that missed extra point. This could open the door for Ottawa here, down just 2 with less than 6 minutes to play. Take it inside the 20. A flag as Williams brings it back. He gets popped but stays on his feet at the 50. And then he's finally tracked down by Hallett. We'll get that flag sorted out when we return here on Friday Night Football in Winnipeg. Football game 25 years ago, as we pay tribute to current and former colleagues calling the game that night. How about that booth? Gord Miller, David Archer, and our dearly departed analyst, Leif Pettersson. Current That's Hockey host, Gino Retta, roamed the sidelines. And enjoying the game in the stands was our gone far too soon CFL and TSN producer and cherished friend, Tony Darcy. 25 years, a long time. Mazzoli, he's going to take a long shot down the field. He's got him. That's a completion at midfield and further. Jalen Acklin, redemption here as he hauls it in. A big play for Ottawa.
A great shot, great catch. Mazzoli to Acklin. It was a familiar scene in Hamilton a year ago. There's that double move, remember? They tried that one a little bit earlier, and he got held up. Acklin got held up by the corner. This time, they make it work.
REDBLACKS have been attacking Rose here a little bit tonight. They found some space around Winston Rose.
Now you wonder how much of the Ottawa vertical game plan.
Williams, no pickup there.
Wonder how much of that vertical game plan has to do with the fact that, you know, as Chez talked about in the pregame, Brandon Alexander,
big-time
playmaker in the middle of that Winnipeg secondary, not in the lineup. Malcolm Thompson, second-year man out of Wilfrid Laurier, making the start at free safety, his first career CFL start.
Mazzoli now 331 yards in his Ottawa debut. And he's got the REDBLACKS back in business again. Looks to his left, goes back into the arms of Adams, and he'll hang on.
Darvin Adams is going to work towards the middle here off his waggle. And a little bit of space there is interesting to see in the Winnipeg defense. You know, we talk all the time about the versatility of Adam Big Hill as a defender. He had dropped back. Big Hill had actually dropped to almost like a second safety. They had two guys deep in the middle. That created that little void on the short side underneath.
Lewis Moore 2 for 2 tonight. This one will put the REDBLACKS on top with 3.5 minutes to play. From the left hash. And it is good. Ward puts Ottawa in front 17-16 after a big play by Acklin to set it up.
A great combination here. Barassa, the long snapper, to Leone, the holder, and Lewis Ward putting it through. Very consistent trio. Special teams, even in a very tough year last year for the Ottawa REDBLACKS.
Lewis is fired up.
As he should be. Putting his team in the lead as a missed extra point by Winnipeg's Mark Leggio looms large.
There were a lot of kicking concerns in the beginning and a good chunk of last season before they went out and got a guy who made a case for himself to be the Grey Cup MVP with what Castillo did in that game. He's now calling Edmonton home. Well, that extra point from Leggio looms large now. Reigning MOP, 18 to 24 tonight for 188 yards. Looked after the ball, has one touchdown. Needs to create something here. Second and 10 on his own 40. Kolaris, pressure coming, gets away, stays on his feet. And that falls incomplete. Looked like he was looking for Rashid Bailey, who was covered very well. REDBLACKS on top here tonight in Friday Night Football. 25-year anniversary of Friday Night Football. We go back to the first game here. Kolaris tonight. Milt getting the job done in that game. Greg Ellingson's been excellent tonight. There's, oh, she's coaching tonight. Big Hill. Few touchdown celebrations along the way. 25 years is a long time. The CFL still terrific. Egg, has challenged for pass interference on that last incomplete pass to Rashid Bailey. And it's a tight look.
Yeah, to me,
Winnipeg has challenged the previous play for pass interference. The play will be reviewed.
And keep an eye here on the halfback from this side, Randall Evans, as he's going to be the guy who makes a little bit of contact as he starts coming downhill in front of this route.
Right there.
And bearing in mind, you're watching a slow motion replay, and in slow motion he arrives, yeah, maybe a split second before the ball. To me, this is football. Let him play. You know, again, as I've said before, if you're going to start calling that pass interference, it's going to become real hard to play defense in this league.
Well, my question to you would be, how does he play that differently? Right? What's he supposed to do different, really, there?
Yeah.
Right? Exactly. So, interesting ruling coming up, and it's a big one in this football game, no doubt about it, as Winnipeg tries to get within field goal range. Let's get the official call on the field.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Third down.
So that'll bring up third down. Mike O'Shea last year only challenged three plays. He won one of them, lost the other two.
Yeah, I think situation dictated taking a shot on that one.
Leggio to kick it away. Down one, 2.5 to play. Williams takes it inside his own 20. Now Williams looked like he might have some room there, but he was gobbled up in a hurry by Cramdy as he was able to hang on and make sure he could go no further. Now Jeremiah Mazzoli is going to have an opportunity to come out here, put together a drive that could possibly put this game away.
Yeah, big series for both teams here. Obviously, Winnipeg, they can turn it over, want to do it quickly with time ticking downward, about 2.5 minutes to go in this ball game. Obviously, they'd like to give their offense as short a field as possible with which to work. And Hamilton going to keep that clock running.
They start on their 30. Crowd at IG Field cranking it up a notch. Ball is handed off, and Willie Jefferson absolutely all over Bennett.
Win on first down goes to the Winnipeg Blue Bombers. They managed to flatten that play out at the line of scrimmage.
Second and 10 for Mazzoli. With a lead on the road in the fourth against the defending Grey Cup champions, near side. It won't be enough either way. But an excellent effort there by Johnson.
Yeah, and you take a look here. Seven men up at the line of scrimmage. Outnumber the blockers. They were going to force it with a second and 10 situation. Basically, forced Mazzoli to get the ball out of his hands before any of his receivers could get to the first down marker.
Rule the catch, so they move that ball to the 35, which is where Leone will let her fly from. Grant a few steps to his left, takes it cleanly, and that return has nowhere to go. And with a minute and 46 seconds left, Kolaris is getting the ball back. 17 career game-winning drives. Got a nice stat here from our ace stat man, John Perlberg. You want to lay that one out there?
Here we go, from the Duke of Digits, John Perlberg. Tonight is the 540th game in Friday Night Football history.
Nice work, Pearly. Good job tracking that one down. We'll keep track of every single one now here in year 25. Kolaros far side looking for Ellingson. And that was almost picked off. Pruneau getting in on it. Yeah. Ellingson got another hand on it after as well.
Couple of Ottawa defenders in the vicinity. Yeah, that throw to the wide side, you know, it's not quite as wide anymore, but that's still a long throw. Giving the defenders time to react and make a play.
Another crack at it here for Kolaros. This time he's going to take off. Zach Kolaros lunging ahead. Hammered at the end of it as he dove head first for the first down. And that is the reigning MOP, putting it all on the line here in game one.
Well, you love the competitiveness of Zach Kolaros, but given his history, I think every fan of this league held their breath when he dove head first here. And especially when he ends up taking a shot, and you completely understand it, honestly, from the point of view of the defenders, you've got to make a play.
This looks like the contact when his head hit the turf might have been even worse than the hit itself.
And you wonder if the spotters with eyes on Zach Kolaros here are...
The injury spotter has asked that number 8, Winnipeg, be removed for 3 plays.
Kolaros is not going to like this.
Well, you know what? He's not going to like it, but... quite frankly, as a big fan of Zach Kolaros, I like it.
Now Drew Brown will come into the game. Brukhoff's the short yardage guy. Brown, technically the backup for situations like this. So no pressure for Drew Brown. Got some action last year. Looked pretty calm with the offense in the preseason. Different stage here with 90 seconds on the clock and his team down by 1 at home to the REDBLACKS. And some early movement. Yeah. That offensive line.
Yeah, procedure. Like... Winnipeg, number 51. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Yeah, the big guy, Jamarcus Hardrick. The right tackle. Came out of his stance a little bit early here. Is take another look. Zach Kolaros, the head first dive. Takes a bit of a shot there. Again, hopefully this is just a precautionary situation with Zach. But it is the right decision by the injury spotters.
Drew Brown put up some pretty good numbers in college, as Kolaros getting chatted with right now on the sideline. Completed 7 passes last season on 14 attempts, did Brown. 3 receivers to his wide side right. That's where he's going to look, and he's got a completion. Gets it into the hands of Schoen, who puts in a great effort. And looks like he's got a first down.
Yeah, great play by a couple of young guys in this clutch situation. Brown coming off the bench. Stepping up and making that throw with a lot of confidence. Schoen recognizing the situation that he's got to get that first down.
Dumping off underneath for Demski. Demski's got a hole. He slips and goes down at the 42. But mission accomplished for Drew Brown. That's the 3 plays. Kolaros has his helmet on the sideline, but they're going to leave Brown in for now. Or one more play, sorry. Brown over the middle again. He's got a completion again. It's Ellingson. He stays on his feet, takes it down inside the 25 to the 20. Drew Brown coming in, getting work done.
Very impressive to get thrown into the fire in this situation. Drew Brown, a quick 3 for 3. And into the red zone.
3 for 3, 51 yards, and has them within field goal range.
All right, decision making critical here. The end zone's great, but you got to protect the ball, protect the field goal position.
From the Ottawa 21, they'll hand it off. Oliveira with a cut back and a nice pickup on first down. What a story is being put together here by Drew Brown and the Bombers.
Well, we talk all the time about
Ottawa,
the need for depth at the quarterback position in order to get through the season in this league. Here we are in week one. Drew Brown steps off the bench. As Brown completing not one, not two, but three in a row.
Three different receivers as well.
Yeah, three different receivers. Very efficient getting his team in range.
Handed off again. Oliveira runs into some trouble, recovers and pushes ahead. With 27 seconds on the clock, that'll bring up third down, and it'll bring out Mark Leggio.
What a terrific drive put together by Drew Brown.
Just speaks to the depth within an organization, yeah. Right?
Yeah. Finding them and preparing them. You know, making sure that it's not just your starting quarterback who's ready to go come game day. You know, we saw last night Jake Mayer came off the bench in Calgary, playing a significant role in that one. Here's Drew Brown one night later.
25-yard field goal attempt from Leggio. He's got it right down the middle. Bombers go on top 19-17. With the most outstanding player in the league last year watching from the sidelines.
Yeah, I cannot come up with another word other than impressive. Again, you don't get thrown into a much hotter fire than that when you're Drew Brown and the kid didn't flinch.
Leggio. 25-yard kick there, but he missed that extra point. Yep. That put his team in the tough spot in the first place. So some redemption there for Leggio. LaPolice not happy, immediately looks at the clock, and he does not have a lot of time to work with here.
Okay, slightly shorter field here, potentially off the return, as teams now kicking off from the 30 rather than the 35.
Kicked away and will be taken at the 20 by Williams. Williams taken down, tripped up just outside the 30 by Ford with 1 second on the clock.
One shot. They've been airing it out all night, so what's one more for Jeremiah Masoli and the Ottawa offense?
One last crack at it here for Mazzoli. Needs a miracle at this point. Steps up, dumps it off underneath. And now it'll be brought all the way back up to midfield a little bit more. Kicked back, controlled. And eventually batted away, scooped up by the Bombers, and that's going to do it. In fitting fashion, the Bombers defense seals it away again after an impressive drive to set up a game-winning field goal. Drew Brown in for Zach Collaros, gets it done. What a night.
Oh, what a night indeed. Some impressive offensive moments for both these teams. New faces in new places making their impact felt. Obviously, hopefully Zach Collaros is all right, but an opportunity presented for Drew Brown. He makes the most of it, stepping up in support of Collaros and the Blue Bombers. Terrific football game to open this season.
The defending champs on a night they celebrated back-to-back Grey Cups here in Winnipeg. They get tested, no doubt about it, but they come away on top. 19-17, your final. Bombers get by the Red Blacks as